Yeah, developing to the west and then gradually spreading east through the evening hours. Take a look outside right now. Pretty quiet in the nearby metro area, not far west, though a bit stormy. 82 degrees southeasterly winds and the pressure down at 29.79. We'll show you our Viper display. This lets us kind of integrate all the area radars and put it into motion. You can watch this little area of occasionally severe storms pushing to the east, and then it is trying to fill in a little bit as you head out into eastern Iowa. These will actually be the storms with the greater potential for severe weather. So let's zoom in for you, and you can see from just to the east of Boxholm, north of Boone, down through Ogden, extending back into areas of northern Guthrie County. Some pretty good thunderstorms, but the atmosphere tonight is not conducive for sustained updrafts. So what will happen is we'll get pulse storms. That means they pulse upward, they're briefly severe for a few minutes, and then tend to kind of quiet down a little bit. Heaviest cell right now located north of Perry. We'll take you in for a closer view there. South of Rippey, right across Highway 144, just south of Berkeley. This little area in here showing some pretty good hail development, probably getting up close to 3/4 to near an inch in diameter. No warning for that storm. You see a brand new lightning strike, but that would be the area for the greatest threat of hail over the next couple minutes. Again, this will last 5-10 minutes and then start to weaken, and we'll watch some other cell try to do the same type of thing. So there is a risk for severe storms tonight. High-end severe weather is not anticipated. Through the evening hours, dropping into the mid-70s, a switch by about 11 o'clock to a north breeze. That'll cool us off to around 62 by 7. Another quick warm-up tomorrow back into the mid-70s. We're pretty much in the 80s across the region. Cold front starting to push on in, and that is generating that little line of weather that we've been talking about. As the wind switches later tonight, a nice, dry, comfortable day tomorrow, even with temperatures pretty close to what we had today. As that front kicks on to the south, we'll go back to that north wind for tonight through the day tomorrow. Partly cloudy conditions, a beautiful day tomorrow with temperatures in the 80s. Here's your computer model. Notice this is for 7 o'clock and how well it has done with where the severe storms are now and forming that line, which will eventually drift on off to the east of the metro as we head a little bit later on tonight. So occasional strong storms kind of bubbling their way on to the east, and then by early on Wednesday morning, they're all out of here. Things quiet on down. A very enjoyable day on Wednesday. So tonight, 62 isolated storms this evening. Again, a few will be strong. We'll watch the radar scan by scan for you just in case anything starts to redevelop. Low 80s for tomorrow. Winds out of the north 5 to 10. That means a little less humid tomorrow. So despite the 80s, it will be a very nice day. Get outside, do a walk or a bike ride. Weekend, just slim chances for precipitation. Early next week, we stay with temperatures in the 80s and hit and miss storms most likely Monday into